In aviation, when a pilot talks about heading, they're not about to headbutt somebody. They're referring to the direction a plane is facing relative to the surface of the Earth. When it comes to building a self-driving car, having a heading can be useful information, as things like GPS will generally give you position, but not which way you're facing. To get that information, we need to rely on magnets, although not ones like this. Think bigger, like the size of the Earth. The Earth itself acts as a giant magnet, although not a very strong one. Scientists believe that the Earth's magnetic field is created by electric currents in the core's conductive material. As it turns out, the geological North Pole looks like the South Pole of a magnet, and the geological South Pole acts like a magnetic North Pole. Earth's rotational axis and the magnetic poles don't actually line up, but they're close enough for general navigational purposes. Interestingly, the magnetic pole in the north, we refer to as the North Magnetic Pole, actually corresponds to a south pole on a magnet, but that really doesn't matter because every few hundred thousand years, the magnetic poles on the Earth switch places. By allowing a bar magnet like this to freely spin, the magnet's north, often painted red, will point toward the Earth's North Magnetic Pole. This works because opposite poles attract, and remember, Earth's North Magnetic Pole is really a south pole. That's great if we're sailing a ship, but how do we get that kind of information digitally? Well, lucky for us, electricity and magnetism are interrelated, and thanks to that, lots of technologies exist that change a voltage, a current, or a frequency based on the strength of a magnetic field. One popular way to detect a magnetic field is a Hall effect sensor. A simple semiconductor Hall effect sensor is just a slab of P-type semiconductor material that has some current flowing through it. As a magnet gets close, the magnetic field causes a deflection in the charge carriers. The electrons will move to one side and the holes will move to the other. This creates a small voltage difference that can be measured, which allows us to indirectly measure the strength of the magnetic field. Recent advances in microelectromechanical, or MEMS, devices have introduced even more ways to detect magnetic fields. One of those includes measuring microscopic movements in a beam that moves in the presence of a magnetic field. Whatever technology is used, this means that we have a variety of sensors at our disposal to get a heading. This is a free-scale MAG3110 magnetometer on a breakout board. It can detect the strength of magnetic fields along three axes. For our purposes, we'll calibrate the sensor so that the heading is given by the direction that the x-axis arrow is pointing. I'll connect VCC and ground to a power cell board that converts LiPo voltage to 3.3 volts. We'll use a MicroView as the main processor and display, but we'll need to program it first. I'll connect 3.3 volts from the power cell to the MicroView's VIN, and likewise with ground. I'll also connect I2C, SCL, and SDA from the magnetometer to the MicroView. Plug the MicroView into a programmer, and plug that into a USB slot in your computer. Note that the MAG3110 is a 3.3 volt part, so we can't use the MicroView programmer with it, as the programmer outputs 5 volts. In a new sketch, write pound include microview.h and pound include sparkfun underscore mag3110.h. Follow that with mag3110 mag equals mag3110 open parentheses close parentheses to instantiate a new object for our magnetometer. In setup, write uview.begin to initialize the MicroView display. Under that, write uview.clear all in capital letters and uview.display to clear the MicroView's memory and display. Finally, write mag.initialize to start the magnetometer. In loop, write //clear display followed by uview.clear page in all capital letters and uview.setcursor 0,0. Then write // if we are calibrated, display heading. Under that, if open parentheses mag.isCalibrated close parentheses, and then uview.setFontType 1. uview.print mag.readHeading, and then delay 100. Assuming we've calibrated our sensor, we want to display our heading as a number on the MicroView. Write close curly brace else open curly brace. Now, if we're not calibrated, we have the MAG3110 Arduino library record the surroundings for the next 5 to 10 seconds to figure out where north is. To do this, we call mag.calibrate regularly while physically rotating the board. We do this because there are likely magnetic fields around us that change the readings from the sensor, and we need to figure out where north is. Note that this only works for the XY axes on the board. We assume that Z will always be pointing up if we're using the board to get a heading. So write // tell user we are calibrating. uview.setFontType0, uview.println calibratin. The G won't fit, so we'll pretend we're in the Wild West. Then write uview.printRotateMe. Under that, // calibrate or enter into calibration mode. If open parentheses mag.isCalibrating, close parentheses, open curly brace, and then mag.calibrate, follow that with close curly brace else open curly brace, and then mag.enterCalMode, close curly brace, and then delay 10. If the software library has not been calibrated, then it will enter into calibration mode where mag.calibrate needs to be called on every iteration of loop. Note that I said software library, as the offsets and scalings derived from calibration are stored on the microview. That means if we cut power to the microview, it will need to run through calibration again. Finally, write uview.display to show the heading or calibration message and make sure loop is closed with a curly brace. Upload this to your microview. Once the microview is programmed, plug it into the breadboard and plug in a LiPo battery. When it powers up, you should see a message that it's calibrating. Slowly rotate the whole device, or at least the sensor, while flat on a surface such as a table. Note that the Z-axis should be pointing up the whole time. When that's done, you should get a heading in degrees. If I point it north, you should see about 0 degrees. West is 90 degrees, south is 180 or negative 180 degrees, and east is negative 90 degrees. The code and circuit for this can be found in the description, but the important thing here is to know how to turn a heading into a number that can be used by your robot. Combine it with something like GPS or rotary encoders, and you can effectively tell your robot to drive east for 2 meters, turn, and then drive northwest for 5 meters. With that, I wish you luck in your self-driving endeavors, fellow navigators. A number that can be used, that technologies exist that do a thing. 100,000 years, is facing relative to the surface of the Earth. Yeah. Magnetic pole in the north is a thing. Magnetic poles and wish you luck in your self-driving endeavors, fellow. Not a heading to something to do that.